Hello everyone and welcome, it's Shanna. Now I got in the mail from Not Too Shabby the Sunflower Fields paper and coordinating ephemera and the sunflower watercolors, and these are simply beautiful. I got hooked on these the other day. I was watching Jamie doing a video and giving a peek at it, and I was like, I have to have this. My sister absolutely loves sunflowers, and so I absolutely had to get this. And then the watercolors are just gorgeous, and of course they're all double-sided, and I'm just showing you all that, but they are just so pretty that I just had to get them. And then as I was sitting there thinking, how did I want to work with them, I decided that I'd bring in LV Handcrafts Easy Wonder Dye 1 and use it. So I'm just showing y'all the ephemera, kind of stacking the ones that I see duplicates of. And that little lady is so cute. There's some smaller ones, some larger ones. There's some wreaths with some die-cut centerpieces out. There's a dog. There's a little girl that looks like my granddaughter. Another little old lady. And just lots of flowers. There's a car, a bike, flower pots. Just a lot of different ones that are just so much fun. I think they're super cute. So I'm going to really look forward to working with this. I'm going to do 2 cards today, but I can assure you, you're going to see more of these on my channel just because I'm in love with this paper. So I've got Lynn's Easy Wonder Dye there. And I'm just going to pick out some watercolor papers and some other papers. And I'm going to just do some die cutting and then come back. So I'll die cut the watercolor papers out, and then we'll use the other patterned paper for the, I guess, bottom layer of our cards is what we're going to do. So I'll get all this die cut out, and then we'll come back and we'll begin working on our cards. So I basically cut out 2 of the watercolored panels there, and then I'm going to bring in this patterned paper here. I thought about using the brown side, but I really liked the floral side. So I'm going to cut this down, and we're going to do a top folding card, and this is going to be just an A2 size panel. And I'm just going to lay my scraps aside. And so I'll just bring in a card base and we'll get to assembling this first card. And I had to cut my card bases earlier today because I was completely out. And I'm just going to score this at 5.5, and we'll just make a top folding card base. And the air just kicked on, so if you hear that extra noise in the background, that's what it is. It has been sweltering. It's been muggy. I mean, you walk outside and it feels like you've stepped into a sauna. And I've got all kinds of glue on that tip of my glue, and it's not coming out very well, and so I'm having to pull the glue off there. And I got a little glue on my panel, so I had to wipe it up and then wipe my hand off. So anyway, I'm going to get this lined up on there, and I think this paper is just beautiful. It would look gorgeous with some green, too, because there's a lot of pretty green in there. But I had already chosen these colors, and I chose them just based upon the ephemera. I thought the kind of brown taupey color and then the more, I don't know, orangey watercolored paper would look really good on here. And so I'm just going to bring a little bit of both in on this card and just add one of the strips. And as you know, or you may know, with the Easy Wonder dies, you've got a nice stitched seam on there. And I'm just going to get this glued down. I'm going to lay my circle down. And I realize when I lay it down, I've kind of got a little bit of a layering issue. So I have got some really thin foam strips, and I'm just gonna, and they're real thin, so they'll work well just for this one layer of paper that I'm trying to accommodate for. And I'm just gonna slide it right underneath there, and then that'll help balance my circle die cut out. And then I've got just the single sunflower here that I'm gonna lay on the circle panel, and I think it's really pretty. It just kind of re-emphasizes the background paper that we've got there. And then I'm going to take this little rectangle die and put it with its orange side up just to kind of bring that orangey color back in. And I thought that looked really cute on there. And I just think this is really pretty. And, you know, you could quit right there and it would be great. But I went to my Better Press and I die cut out some floral sentiments. And I thought I would get it added to it. So, and I used the Bark Betterpress ink cube, and so it's got a real nice dark brown color to it, and I think it looks really nice with what I've got going on with this card. So I'm just bringing in some more of those thin foam strips and just gonna pop this up just a little bit. It won't be a lot of dimension, but enough to create some interest on our card. And I think it looks really, it really comes together nice. So I'm gonna lay that down on there, and I'm gonna straighten it up because it's crooked, and I think it looks really pretty. And so I've got this little strip of paper that I'd cut away, and I'm gonna lay it on the inside because I'm gonna use the paper, and I got too much glue on there, so just wiping it off with my finger, we'll get it lined up. And then I'm gonna grab another piece of ephemera because I've got plenty of ephemera here, so I can certainly put some on the inside of the card as well. And I'll just grab a small flower and just try to figure out where I wanna put it. And I just decide to go with the lower left-hand corner. I'm gonna lay down on there. And that'll pretty much finish up our first card, I think. Actually, I think I'm gonna move on to the next card. It's this card that I add the embellishment to. I was thinking it was that one. So I'm gonna make this one a top folding landscape card. And so I'm gonna trim this down, and I don't know what I trim this down to, because I get it trimmed down, and then later you'll see that it doesn't even fit the card panel. So I'm not really sure what measurements I use there. I'm gonna use this circle piece here that die cut out that you can make a shaker window with, and I'm just measuring it, because I'm gonna frame it. I've got this brown paper, and so I just measured it so that I could put a nice little edge around that, and I'm just going to frame it up and just use it for a shaker window. And it's going to pretty much cover up most of that pattern paper. There'll be a little bit peeking around there, but it's going to be a pretty nice focal point. So I'm going to get, I had a mini slimline acetate panel, and I just took one of my circle dies that was larger than this opening here, and just die cut it out. And then I'm trying to peel off the protective film that is on there right now. And we'll just get it pulled off. And I'm going to use my tape runner and just run it along the inside of that panel and adhere my acetate with that. And then I won't have to mess with any glue and make it a mess. And we'll just lay that circle down on there. And I think I'm just going to grab my bone folder and just kind of push it down and make sure I get a really good adherence on there. And I was first using the flat side, then I realized the pointed side, I could just kind of go right along that tape line and get a really nice adherence down on there. And now I'm looking for my Gina K shaker strips, and I don't know where they are. So I'm gonna get another package out of my desk there and use them. And hopefully the other ones will turn up. And for this card, I've actually lost, I'll go looking for the sentiment. And I lost it for quite a while. And it was actually sitting on my chair beside me, and I didn't know it. It took me a minute to find it. But anyway, so I'm just going to lay these strips down here and create a little well for our little shaker bits. And then I'm going to miss a step here because I forgot what I had in mind, and I'm going to press these down with my bone folder and get a real good adherence, and then I'll pull the bottom one off and the two sides and get my panel attached to it. And this is where I'm forgetting that I wanted to put a piece of the ephemera on the inside of it, but I'll figure it out. And what was funny was I was so impressed with myself that I actually got it laid down on there nice with a nice little edge around there, because sometimes I struggle with that. But anyway, I'm realizing, oh, I was going to put this little girl on the inside. So I'm going to just get some glue on her and just kind of pry that one side apart, tuck her down in there, and then try to push her down. I'm going to bring my bone folder in and kind of run it across there just so that glue adheres. And I don't get it perfectly adhered because I struggle a little bit when I get my shaker bits in there, but I am able to work around it. And it did work out. So I'm just gonna pull it apart and just drop some of those in there. and some of them want to sneak behind her, and so I'll turn it sideways and shake them out. And then we'll add some more in there and get them down in there, shake it out a little bit. And then I'm going to pull off that last little bit of release tape and then just push it down with my bone folder so we have a good adherence. So we've got a nice little amount of those kind of orangey golden shaker bits in there. And so now I'm going to lay it down on my card base. And you can see I'm just going to have a little sunflower edge hanging out there. And I'm actually going to create my card base. That was just my panel. And so I'm going to create it. I need to just spend some time and just start scoring all those and getting them ready so I don't have to do it on camera. But I've just been cranking out content and not really getting my materials in order. So I need to do that. So this is where I'm like, what did I do? So I just go cut it again so I'll have a white edge around there because I didn't want to waste it, and get it laid down on there. I have no idea what the dimensions were that I went with, but we'll get this laid down on there and just get it positioned, and we'll get it glued up and laid down. Now, today was my day off. I didn't have the boys, and my husband and I did a bunch of errand running. We actually went grocery shopping, went to two grocery stores, because that's what he normally does. And I don't normally go with him because I don't like to grocery shop, but felt like maybe today I could just spend some time with him and do that. And anyway, we got home and I realized that I didn't get a sweet onion because I'm wanting to do cucumbers and onions salad, and I didn't have a sweet onion. So I wound up going to a third grocery store after we got home. We have one close to our home, and I decided I needed to take a walk. And so I just walked over to the grocery store and picked up a sweet onion and came back home. So I went to three grocery stores today. And then we actually did quite a bit of cleaning at the house since the kids weren't here. We shampooed the carpets again, which we like to do that pretty regularly, and did some cleaning around the house. And then most of the time spent crafting. I did, I don't know, maybe three or four videos in a short today. So just cranked some stuff out, and I'm just finishing up this voiceover this evening. This should run tomorrow morning. And then I'm going to go to sleep because the kids will come back tomorrow. And this week school starts, so that'll be something new because my three-year-old grandson will be going to preschool, and that'll be new. So our schedule's going to change a little bit, so we'll just see what happens. So I'm just going to pop this cinnamon up, and this is the one that I had that had gone missing and was laying on my chair beside me. And I was glad I found it because I was like, oh, geez. You know, the better pressed paper and ink and everything you hate to waste. So I was glad I found it. But I think this turned out really cute. This little ephemera, piece of ephemera, reminds me of my little granddaughter. She's got dark brown hair and dark eyes, and she's just beautiful. And I just thought this kind of reminded me of her. So I'm going to put three little dots of glue down there, and I'm going to bring some more of those shaker bits in, and they're just little flat pieces, and I'm just going to lay them down there and just bring that shine back in on the outside of the card. And I'm kind of fooling around trying to get them picked up. I'm trying to decide if they're one side's better than the other, but I don't think so. And we'll just arrange them with the tip of our tool there. And actually, when I did that, I pulled up one, so there were two stacked together. So we're going to position down on there. I think these cards turn out really pretty. And I've got all these other pieces from LV's dies that I have stored with the ephemera and the pattern paper, and I'll have them to use. So I'm sure you'll be seeing this pattern paper again on my channel. So thanks for watching. I hope you like it. Have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.